Welcome to IANS TV. Today we have Mr. Vinod Rai, who is a former Comptroller and Auditor General of India. He is considered as an upright bureaucrat. He has his own share of controversies in the Comptroller as a Comptroller Auditor General of India in the report which was published for the 2G spectrum allocation. Mr. Rai, my first question is that did you think the CBI the CAG report, did it help CBI building a good case?
Look, I must clarify that the CAG does audit. The CBI does investigation. There is nothing common in these two. But the documents that we relied upon, those documents, the CBI also must have looked up. But CBI's basic job is investigation, which means we don't question people. We looked at records, we asked some questions, we get answers to those audit queries, and we do a report. CBI goes into investigations, it gets witnesses, it can summon witnesses, it can do searches, it can look at bank records. We don't do all that. So it's two very different things.
And the second question is linked to the first question. The Supreme Court, everybody knows they cancelled the licenses, the 122 licenses, because Supreme Court saw that they were malafide. There was malafide. But the trial court judge, he said the case is not made out and he acquitted everybody in the case. So how do you explain this?
Yeah, see, because these are three very different agencies, number one, doing three different kind of activities. I explained to you about audit. Audit looks at records, raises audit queries, gets answers, prepares a report, puts it into parliament, and their job is done. Okay, it's discussed by PSC, that's a different thing. The second is the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court goes by the witnesses, the evidence, and the documents that are produced before it. And in this particular case, the Supreme Court in its judgment has written that we are not relying upon the report of the CAG because that report is before Parliament and is being debated in the PSC. So Supreme Court went entirely by an independent set of evidences, witnesses, documents, whatever it was, and they cancelled the licenses. The third is the CBI's investigation. Now, acquittal depends upon the amount of evidence that the prosecution can give forth. Now, if you read the judgment or operative part of the trial court judgment, he very clearly writes that the charge sheet had a certain accusations, the evidence has not borne out those accusations. So he in fact goes, and in my book I've written that he says the quality of evidence was miserable. That's the word he's used. So acquittal has nothing to do with the cancellation that was done by the Supreme Court. These are two entirely different things.
Yeah.
One is looking at criminality, the other is looking at irregularity.
Well, this led to a major problem with the Congress leader, because they were all gunning for you. They were actually abusing you for this report. And Kapil Sibal said that there's zero loss. And Prime Minister, a former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, he did not contradict him. He said no auction, hence no basis to calculate loss. What do you have to say on this?
See, well, people have their opinions. It's a free country. They air their opinions, and I'm nothing against them, absolutely, because I mean they have a viewpoint, and they address that viewpoint. But as far as our audit report was concerned, when we said that there was a revenue foregone, the licenses which were cancelled by the Supreme Court were auctioned later, if you remember. And the amount that was realized in that auction was exactly the amount that we had pointed out.
So it was the presumptive loss was
actually was realized. So if somebody has to say that there was zero loss, then how do you justify the fact that you've got 66,000 crores in an auction that you've done for the same license?
So this, you know, even the CBI chief AP Singh, he had mentioned that, you know, 50,000 crore loss in the parliament. He has mentioned that there was a loss of 50,000 crore, and probably after once the investigation is complete, we'll be able to finalize it. So it's apparent that your report helped the CBI to build a good case.
See, if the, I'm not privy to this, the fact that the director of CBI made a statement to the parliament that 50,000 crores had been lost. But yes, he may have said it.
Yeah, lost with the exchequer. Yeah. This is what he had.
Yeah, whether he could justify that figure in an investigation, I really don't know. Mm. But I'm aware of the fact that the cabinet secretary conducted an independent checkup on his own, and he reported that yes, loss has been there, but it's about 36,000 crores. So various
initially,
things.
As far as I remember, initially CBI started with the 30,000 loss theory.
That's right.
And, you know, so it was basically somewhere between 30,000 and 50,000 they were calculated. But it's a huge amount. Still, it's a huge amount.
It's a huge amount. And that's why within the government itself, there was a feeling that this zero loss does not withstand scrutiny, you know?
Yes. So, I've also come to know that Dr. Manmohan Singh was your professor, and he has taught you. So you had, you know, this, and he supported. He did not contradict Kapil Sibal. So did it lead to any bad blood between and him?
Certainly not. I must tell you that I have great amount of regard for Dr. Manmohan Singh. Yes, I was when he was teaching in 1969. I was in the Daly School of Economics, and he has taught us also in that class. But you see, as I said, people air opinions. We don't have to. I mean, whether he supports me, doesn't support me, doesn't really matter. He supports that viewpoint, and that's very fair. I mean, just because say AP Singh, or as you are saying, Director CBI said 50,000 rupees, and we said 1,76,000, doesn't matter. We have a methodology by which we calculated what we calculated. Mm. Okay, they have a methodology by which they made their assertions. It's a viewpoint, it's a free country. Why should I feel disappointed or let down?
So there was a loss. That's for sure. Was a loss.
You mentioned that Director CBI said it, and the cabinet secretary.
Now, when there is a loss, it's a loss to the national. It's loss to the nation. So Manmohan Singh also said that, you know, it's there in the media also that, you know, he was not aware of the motive behind these companies. You know, the companies who had actually gone for the 2G licenses. You know, when we talk about good governance, if the spectrum is, you know, allocated to certain companies whose motives are unknown, is it not causing loss to the governance, and it actually causing loss to the national security?
Yeah, because you see, what happened was, this was spectrum being given out for telephony. Mm. So ordinarily, it should have gone to telephone companies. Mm. But we found that there were real estate companies who took licenses. That is probably what he was referring to, that he did not know the motivation for why a real estate company is buying a spectrum license, you know?
Yeah.